Hi ladies, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back. As you guys know, my name is Sugar Bell. Welcome back to my channel. This week's video will be me doing my brows. How to get the perfect brows, okay ladies? We'll also have a little bit of a chit chat, girls talk in this video, so that's where that go. Keep watching. Don't forget to like. Leave a comment down below in the comment section and share, subscribe, you know, all these good things. If you guys can do that, I'll greatly appreciate it. Love you all. To see me snatch my breath, just keep on watching. Hi guys, welcome again. We are going to be doing our brows today. One of them is with pencil and the other one is a hack, and that's by using a matte brown eyeshadow. I am going to start off with a pencil. I'm going to do pencil on one eye and then I'm gonna do the eyeshadow on the other eye. Okay. I had some pencils, and to be honest, I did some moving around and stuff, and I cannot, for the life of me, I cannot find my pencils. The one that I found is a crystal. This, from all we can find. So, this is what we're going to do. I'm going to draw a line under the natural shape of my brow, where my brow hairs stop, the base of my brow hairs. Now don't try to force this, just follow the natural line of your brows. That one. Now many persons, I can just do that by itself and still get arch of my brow the way I want it, right in here. Alright, now the arch of your brow, for those of you who don't, you know, don't do brows, don't do brows, the arch of your brow is pretty much where the tail and the beginning of your brow meet in the middle of here. Now the best way to find the arch of your brow while doing your brow, or to get it perfect or properly, is to hold right here of the forehead. So when you're drawing your brow, you can do this. Just hold it up like this and do your marking, right? Because then that creates the natural effect of the brow. If it's a case where you don't clean up your brow by yourself like me, because you don't know how to do it, that's totally fine. If you go to like, I know most days you go to like a barber or to shape the brow, that is, or you might go to a salon or someone to get it waxed or whatever it is. Normally, whoever would do it, they would find the natural arch in your brow, or they create an arch. In most cases, they will create an arch, because not everybody have that deep arch. But when they wax in, most people, when they wax the eyebrow, they will try putting that deep arch in it. But yeah, that's one way of getting a good arch or a perfect arch for the brow. Now, I'm going to draw another line at the top of the brow. Now, this line will not go all the way up here. Why? Because I see some persons, when they're out and about, they do the brows, they actually darken right in here, in the inner part of the brow. They darken in this up, you have to look like you put on one sharpening marker on the eye. Now, you start out somewhere about here, right? That's quite a little space right here. And you draw up where the ears are. You can go higher, but for those of you who are just, you know, practicing, just learning, I'd recommend that you stick to your natural brow outline. Don't go high, don't go low. Because chances are you're not going to do it right. Okay? Now, after you've done that, shading the tail of the brow, just the tail, ensure that there are no sparse areas, shading right this up. Okay? Then in here, for most persons, in this area is a little bit thicker than the rest, right? So you don't have to do that much shading. The tail is normally sparse with hairs, but not that much over here, right? So for me, this is the bottom that needs a little extra care. You know, I don't go past where this line is at the top, right? And I'm going to show you why. But even though the bottom line was all the way out here, it served a purpose over there. Okay? So that? Cool. Now I'm going to use a spoolie and comb. Now you comb this up. So the line that is at the bottom, you get diffused into the rubbing up here. So you see that natural look at the front? That's what we were working for. And comb through the rest of the brow. Now it might look untidy. Why? Especially if you're using a pencil like the one that I have. It's a wax pencil. They can be annoying because when you brush, it picks up everything and transfers it. Under here and up here start looking messy. Yep. So we're going to go in with concealer. I'm just going to use my LA Girl Pro Concealer. Yes, so this one I will use above the brow bone, or at the top of the brow bone. Alright, so I use Toffee for the top, and I'm going to use Fawn for under the brow. Right? Now all that I'm gonna do, I can just use the brush part of the concealer today, but I'm not going to. I'm going to put it on the back of my hand and work from there. Then I'm gonna use flat brush. It's a detailer brush. This is what it looks like. Yes, I'm gonna use Fawn under the brow. I'm just going to carve out that brow. Now, when choosing the concealer for your brows, it's best to use a concealer that is at a shade or two lighter than your skin tone or your complexion. I use a darker concealer that is closer to my skin tone for the top. Why? Because when I'm doing foundation, it blends better. Then I'm gonna be using this little fluffy brush right here. Now these brushes, you can get them from Amazon. That's where I bought mine. I'm just gonna use that and blend out the two colors. I'm gonna start with the top one first. Why? Because it's the darker shade. I don't want to blend the lighter shade into the darker shade. It will always stick together, but when your sweat mix with it, that will start separate. So you're gonna see the sweat different from the skin, different from the concealer one bit. But when you set it with powder, it's not gonna go nowhere. Okay? So you can use this on regular face powder, anyone that matches your skin tone. For ladies who don't want to do any more makeup than just this, that's all you gotta do. Okay? Just set it with powder. Depends on the extending my eyebrow a little bit.
There is one thing I need to say. You ladies who are drawing on the eyebrow, go weird on yourself, and if you stop it, please make a big old room. Top it. Massa got name who on the eyebrow, go weird on yourself.
Don't laugh. I say it, but I say it. Right? So we are shaving. Okay, so.
We are going to clean up with our concealer.
Brush your mouth and the tongue will brush. The tongue, happy brush. Before you go to bed, brush and floss and rinse before you go to bed, just the same. Try to have that habit. Next thing is use of deodorants. This is a very simple one, but different deodorants cater to different needs.
Okay.
For us women with hormonal issues who produce more male hormones, how you call it? Yeah. You tend to sweat more, and because of that, the sweat, the perspiration also comes off with a much more smelly odor, and you tend to smell quicker than a normal female. It, you know, seem unfair, but that is nature, how nature works. Now, there are different brands that cater to women like these that are with these issues. Secret has a very good one, a sensitive care, and you have Dove that has one, and Degree as well. Try and find these deodorants. They may be somewhat priced on the pricier end as in comparison to regular Dove or Secret or regular So yeah, deodorant. Once a day, put on deodorant. Much time if you be pretty, let's have a clue. But you don't be less than one. Okay? Being around people, you having your own body odor is all good and fine, but when you're around people, ensure that you have a little freshness, a little, you know, presentable smell. Yeah, if that makes sense. That will make persons more comfortable around you. They'll want to talk to you, they'll want to be around you. And that's it. I think that should be the aim of being around people, having them wanting to be around you, you know. So yeah, do that. The next thing that I'm going to go into as it relates to moving and, you know, taking care of ourselves as it is the washing of the hair. Now, what you mean? Has anybody who knows me knows that I don't like dealing with my hair. Maybe I like pull my ear, no like wash my ear, maybe I like doing nothing at all related to my hair. Very sorry. Okay? However, when it comes to the cleanliness of my hair, you're not supposed to tell me something that's special side. No, not that. Because I'm my pride, I want me know, it not gonna happen. And I think it should be the same for every single female. I know a lot of us wear a lot of extensions and weaves and stuff like that. Make sure that they smell good, no mama. Make sure that they smell good. So when they go beside somebody, they don't have to wonder why I'm gonna smell. They just like keep like fan and stuff. They basically beat a little wash or something like that. Or spray something in it to make it smell good. Okay? If you're wearing a natural hair, your hair is supposed to wash like once a week or once every 2 weeks, bearable, whatever it is that you choose. But it's not supposed to be a case where you go out and dry scalp and just put your hair and your head smell that much. Come on, ladies, like take pride in yourselves. Okay, we're not talking to a specific person, but all of us have flaws. Understand? And like I said, this particular one, it's for me because me don't like wash my hair. But at the same time, you will not get me go out there and have somebody say, ah, Jesus, it's not bad. No. As much as me not like wash my hair, if I even feel spray, send it in there to make it smell good. I'm just spraying on them in a mean perfume. There are hair products out there that caters to smell. Counteract like certain moisturizers, certain gels, certain, you know, these products that we use are supposed to use and are often as we hear to use it. Most of them have fragrances and pleasant fragrances. I try to use these things and these things while I'm in here, man. But Jesus Christ, somehow we put in the wig and we left the wig in there for almost months. And we have not talked to the wig and the wig starts stink. And we go in a taxi. We travel beside people, we work with people, we rub up beside them, and yet end up kick like a van down. It's not normal. It not look good. It not smell good. Fuck it. Okay? We cannot be like this, okay? At 2020. We have enough crisis to deal with. So start over the ear part like, okay? The other thing is dealing with our nails. Now, and not ever grooming your nails as females doesn't mean that you have to have on the latest trend of false nails. You're not having your false nails. You're not having to go on nail finish and groom your nails, clean your hand them properly and your toes them. You don't need to. Simple thing. At home, get one nail clip and one nail file. Even on your nail clip, fine. Get a nail file, shape up your nails and clean out underneath the cuticle area and stuff like that. Right? File them up properly, trim them up properly. If you want to, you get some clear polish and polish the nails. You can use colored polish if you want. Put some shampoo over it and that is it. Rub little lotion on your hand. Lotion is very essential to the skin as well, because the skin needs moisture and that's what lotion provides for the body. So ladies, use lotion on your skin. I personally look at these things when I see someone, especially your hands. If as a female, no matter how much hard work you do, your hand has to be, your hand will look like a man. No matter how when you work on construction site, mama. Yeah, and nothing have as much callus as a man. Enough man out there work on construction site that you come on and you stop it. Lotion your hands. Take care of your fingers and properly ensure that they're clean and pretty. Yeah, hook. You have the little brushes that are so good.
Destroys the nails, fine. Use a little top coat all right then. Understand, give it a little machine, ensure that you clean up properly, you know, the cuticle area, clean out and stuff like that. And you know, you don't have no ever dead skin on your foot and you know, after you don't always have to go to a salon or a nail technician to do these things for you. You understand? You can do these things at home. The callus that normally grows on the bottom of the feet. So you can do is get a basin with some warm water and add some Epsom salt to it and some baking soda. Put your foot in it, the soap. You can even use conditioner. That's not what you want to say, my mother used to. Sit and drink that money. Yeah. She put what? Conditioner, another hot water, another warm water. Put her foot in it, the soap for 1 to 5 minutes. The little wooden filing sell on every single Chinese shop. Every Chinese harbor that you can find it. And we always have one Chinese shop everywhere. Now every little vicinity a Jamaica. So nobody on an excuse. And then cheap. You can get one like thing that one got it up. Yeah. And you have the little foot file and I'm a little callus
So just some basic things, we can do some little teeny things we can do that makes a huge difference in our appearance. With your hair too, not only that we're going to wash it whenever or however often we're supposed to, but also comb it. You know, you have a funny street road. Catch up your hair if you don't want a big style, catch up if you don't want neatly. You understand? Do some nice, cute little styles, go out and stuff. If you are going to wear afro, and I am hands down an afro fan, anybody who knows me, I love my afro hair to my heart. But put on a cute little headband around it, spice up the thing a little bit, make it look neat and presentable, use little gel, get little edges and all these things. You can't just go out and look it dry like that, mama. It can't work. Understand? And then these things help to boost our self-esteem too. Understand? And that's what it should be about. Being the best version of ourselves. And this will make you quite happy. Okay? You don't have to do the whole bag of things. You don't have to go out there to spend one bag of money for the hairdresser or go sit in front of a nail technician every 2 weeks. No! Okay, everybody that find him, nobody not have the time to spend no money and nobody not have no money to spend. I might do videos in the future that shows you how to do some of these things from home. So even some of us who can't afford to be going to the salon and stuff like that, you can do some of these things at home. And like me say, what's in this video are practical things where you can go on the yard. Understand? So yeah, just continue to do your thing. Add one and two tips and tricks from this video to your life. See how well it works out for you. And I wish you guys all the best. Looking forward to seeing you in my next video.